In the past, you may have used the Razor's Edge mobile app to access your database on the go. In this demonstration, we will review accessing the Razor's Edge NXT web view using your mobile device's browser. We'll cover several tasks together. We will cover adding a constituent record, searching for a constituent record, adding an organizational relationship to a constituent record, adding a note to a constituent record, adding an action to a constituent record, and adding a gift to a constituent record. We will also review adding an opportunity to a constituent record. We will review the prospect management tile of a constituent record, review the work center functionality, review the list functionality, and review the reporting functionality as it exists in Razor's Edge NXT using our mobile device. Let's get started. You've met Bob McBones, a general manager for several local grocery stores, at a welcome week event for your university. Bob tells you that his daughter will be graduating from your school soon, and he's been wanting to make a sizable contribution. Also, Bob would like to have that contribution matched by his company's matching gift program. You and Bob agree to meet for dinner to discuss his donation. But before you can meet Bob for dinner, you need to get everything in Razor's Edge before you forget. Let's create a new constituent record for Bob in RENXT using our mobile device. Starting from the task tile on the home screen of Razor's Edge NXT, choose Add a Constituent. To add an individual, I'm going to first search for Bob's title among the available field values in my database. Next, I'll enter Bob's name. I'll also enter Bob's suffix from the available values in my database. I'll also enter Bob's preferred name and his gender. If Bob gives me his address information, I can enter his preferred address, either using the search functionality in RENXT or choosing not to enter his address using the search functionality. I'm also adding a valid from date, as well as marking his address as primary. If Bob gives you his preferred phone number, I can also enter this information as well and mark it as primary in Razor's Edge NXT. I'm also going to enter Bob's email address and mark it primary as well in Razor's Edge NXT. Next, I'm going to add a constituent code from the values available in my database, as well as set the start date for that value. Lastly, I'm going to select Bob's name formats for his primary addressee and primary salutation before saving Bob's record. And here you see Bob's new record. Once I've created Bob's constituent record, I can now search for Bob in my database. Using the magnifying glass in the upper left-hand corner, I can start to type Bob's name. When Bob appears in my search results, I'll select Bob to go directly to his constituent record. From the home screen in Razor's Edge NXT, I can also select the recently accessed tile. This tile gives me access to every constituent record that I've looked at recently or created recently. And there you go, there's Bob's new record. Now that we've created a constituent record for Bob, let's add an organization relationship for his company, as well as a note to his constituent record. Having clear relationship code values, as well as notepad types in our database, will help us accomplish this task pretty quickly using our mobile device. To add a relationship to Bob's constituent record, start by scrolling down to the relationship tile. Clicking the Add button will allow me to search for a constituent in my database or add a new one if I need to. You can see that we're able to easily add the employee-employer relationship codes to this particular relationship record. We can also set a date for this relationship to start, as well as identify Bob as a contact type for his organization. We can include Bob's position if we know it, and also check the box for this being Bob's primary employment information. Remember, in the web view, you can rearrange the order of your tiles on the constituent record. So if you're using relationships, actions, or notes pretty regularly, you might want to move those to the top of your constituent records in the web view. I can add a note to Bob's record as well. Scrolling down to the notes tile and clicking Add Note gives me the opportunity to add one of the note types in my database to Bob's record. I can summarize that note. I can use the copy-paste function in my mobile device to copy the same note that I added to his organization relationship, or I can enter an entirely new note. The key here is to make sure that I capture all of the details of my conversation with Bob on my mobile device. Let's add an action to Bob's record about our dinner meeting to discuss his donation. Start by scrolling to the action tile on Bob's constituent record. I'm going to first start by adding the category of the action. This is a meeting. I'm also going to set the action type. It's a dinner. I'm also going to summarize the action as well as add some notes. I can set the start date and time of the action, as well as download this appointment to my calendar of choice. I can add additional action details, as well as assign the actions to myself or another fundraiser if I need to. Keep in mind that after I've saved this action to Bob's record, I can also go back and mark this action as completed. A key thing to remember about all text fields, such as notes. If I have the microphone enabled on my mobile device, I can enter these notes using dictation and speak them directly into my mobile device. Your dinner with Bob went great. He gave you a check for $100. He said that you should follow up with him in a week. You should also be hearing from his donor-advised fund manager. Let's enter that check on Bob's record. Let's scroll down to the gift history tile on Bob's record. Clicking the Add Gift button, I can start by entering a gift amount. I can edit the gift date as well as the receipted amount for that gift. I can also choose to use the gift amount as the receipted amount. I can mark Bob's gift as anonymous if I need to. As this is a cash gift, in the web view, it's known as a one-time gift. I can choose from the appropriate payment methods in my database. I can also enter appeal, fund, package, and campaign descriptions from the available values in my database. I can also add soft credits to Bob's gift or split his gift between different funds and appeals or campaigns if I need to. I can edit whether or not Bob's gift has been acknowledged, receipted, or posted. I also have the option to add fundraiser credit to Bob's gift. I can credit myself or another fundraiser if I need to. I can also add a custom gift attribute or custom field, as they're known in the web view, for Bob's gift.
Let's add an opportunity to Bob's record, also known as a proposal in database view. In order to add a new opportunity to a constituent, pull up their record and find their opportunity panel. Click on Add Opportunity and fill out your information. It defaults to being assigned to the fundraiser for that constituent. There is also a Me option if you want to assign it to yourself as well. And if there is a campaign fund, gift type, or likelihood, you can fill that out as well and click Save. You can also check on the prospect status of the constituent here on the prospect management panel, where you can also see the status history of when they were in which status and for how long. If you are set up as a fundraiser, when you log into RENXT on your mobile device, you should open on your work center. If you're not, then you can go into fundraising and select work. The Work Center has all of the people that are assigned to you or another fundraiser if you pull up their information, and has an area where there is the portfolio, their actions, their opportunities, and their gifts that are associated with those constituents in your portfolio. You can click on any one of these items to see those details. And you can also filter upon these items to look at a subset. There is also the Needs Attention area under the overview, which tags constituents with pieces of information that may need follow-up, such as an overdue pledge or a recent gift or event registration. You can add an action directly from here if it is something you need to follow up on, or you can dismiss if it is not. You can also access lists by clicking on the three horizontal lines at the top left, selecting lists and the type of list you would like to work with. Any lists you had open on any other logins will display here as well. You can open additional lists by clicking on the plus sign and selecting Open a Saved List. Or you can also build lists from scratch on the go. You can also view your dashboards by going into fundraising reporting, whether that's one of these pre-configured dashboards that are already here for you, or you can also open custom dashboards here that you have created. Thank you for joining us today for this tutorial on how to use RENXT from your mobile device.